Abraham, God's friend. Abraham became the friend of God by his manifestation of faith, when in response to God's invitation, he left his own country and wandered in Canaan. By his obedience, he became heir of the promise. In thee and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. St. Paul explains that Abraham's wife represented this covenant or promise. Sarah's barrenness corresponded to the long-deferred coming of Christ in fulfillment of the promise. Isaac typified Messiah, the heir of the promise. Isaac's bride, Rebekah, typified the elect church, the bride of Christ, and his joint heir in the promise. St. Paul says that Hagar typified the law covenant made with Israel at Mount Sinai, and that the nation of Israel was typified in Ishmael. As Hagar and Ishmael were cast off when Isaac was born and had almost perished, so the Jewish people have been cast off from divine favor for 18 centuries, and today are nearly famished. As the angel of God pointed to the fountain of water and Ishmael was revived, so God's message now is pointing the Jews to a spring of water. Their Zionistic hopes are reviving. The sacrifice of Isaac typified the sacrifice of Christ, necessary in order for him to become the spiritual seed of Abraham with power to bless the world. The servant sent to call Rebekah, the bride of Isaac, is beautifully explained to represent the work of the Holy Spirit in calling the church to become the bride of Christ and his associate in the great work of blessing Israel and all the families of the earth. Rebekah's return with Eliezer represents the church's journey during this gospel age to meet Christ, the bridegroom who will receive her at his second advent. Abraham typified Jehovah God, through whose promise the blessing of all the families of earth will come. This promise has been the hope of Israel for 35 centuries.